Put your hands together for the magnificent, the wonderful Anthony G. Bentley.
Have I run the app?
I still can't get word.
His nickname was Camp. His name was Compton.
How long
did
you work with Compton?
I started in 2015, September 22nd. That's when I received the revelation to go into action with this vision. Osaka, Japan, in a shrine. That's when I received the revelation, I like to say. More questions? So yeah, wherever it is that you choose to do, maybe you might not do it now, but I'm almost certain if you really sincere with yourself, that's where the power will come from as well. It's actually being sincere and true with self. Because once you do that, then everything else coming forward will be true as well. Because you're acting on truthness. Because you can easily pretend or put on an act. Do it to yourself, you just sabotage yourself. So I learned that's where the actual power comes, being with yourself. And then that will just automatically come out. So again, you know, coming from that type of behavior, growing up, I was able to, you know, have other encounters that shyness was preventing me from not taking advantage of opportunities. So when I got to the point where enough was enough, you know, I just really wanted to get over this presence that, you know, I would feel. And I would say about maybe 18, 19. That's when I started to pretty much start breaking out and start being more aware of self. I think a lot of my journey also comes from awareness of self, knowing the things that, you know, you may discover about yourself within life. You know, even with this, you know, speaking now, first time doing it, but I just do it. Just do it. Don't even be so concerned about the mess up. I think that was another thing, too, I learned about shyness, because you're afraid that you're going to mess up and somebody might say, hey. And I learned that kind of like putting the harness on you too, the fear of that. Even though I may have the talent to do it, and other people thought that as well, but it's just the outside voice about it. He ain't nothing or whatever. That had an effect, but not anymore. You know, even with this company, you know, Natalia, she's a fox, right? And can you pass me my bag? No, you got the camera. Does someone pass me that bag? Please. He's a fox. And I walk around with this fox. And, you know, people in Japan, and, you know, or even when people see me on social media, you know, they say, I see you and your little buddy. But it takes courage to walk around with a stuffed animal like this to do what I do. You know? It really does, because, you know, first of all, people will say, dang, why is this old guy playing with a toy? You know? It's okay. But they don't know my vision, they don't know my direction. They don't know that one day this has the opportunity to be another Diddy. And that's what I see. Disney is Disney, Hello Kitty is Hello Kitty, Fantabulous is Fantabulous. This is what I see. And I'm seeing it happen. I mean, even for me to be speaking now, it's like, I didn't set this up. And again, that comes from where? I just came up to this school to actually reminisce, you know, back in the playground. I was, I like to call my home office the lab. So I computer to work and, you know, I said, well, I'm gonna take a break, I'm just gonna take a walk. And I said, let me just walk up to this, you know, the school, St. Clair Elementary, right, to go to school, because I never been in the back, right? I had came inside the school before, but I never went in the back. So I go in the back of the school, and that's how I met Mr. Stone. You know, because I was looking at the garden that they had back there, the little playground. I'm thinking when I was, you know, lunchtime, go out there playing with my friends, playing kickball and baseball. And, we used to call it the old building, the old St. Clair, but we nicknamed it the old building. So that's how I met Mr. Stone. He was in his vehicle. So he came up, you know, greeted me, and I wanted to, you know, let him know immediately that, you know, I'm just here reminiscing, you know, that I didn't want to think that I'm up here, you know, being, you know, up here for some wrong cause, whatever. So we had a brief conversation, and this is how it all came about. That night when I went to sleep, I woke up and I'm just laying in bed. That's one of my rituals. I just laying in my bed, and I just entertained my imagination. And then it came to me. I'm like, wow. I would love to, you know, share my experience at this school with the students if they're allowed to. And the interesting thing about that was 2 days before that, I was on the computer making a video for my website that was just, I was making a video for the website, and one of the stories that I used was the story I just mentioned about me in the gym class. So I'm like, wow, so my awareness is capturing all what's been taking place. And all I can do was smile and say, you know, thanks to the creator of life. You know, that's, I like to call it by that name. Thanks for the creator of life. You know, you don't plan stuff like that. And that's basically how my life pretty much took off, even in Detroit. And making, you know, my dreams and visions come true. Just going forward. You know, growing up on the east side of Detroit, you know, it was tough. Had fun too, but I knew the environment was also dictating my lifestyle. So I was playing a part of my bike. A lot of gang activity going on and stuff like that. And by me, you know, loving to play basketball, I stayed at the recreation center that we called the Rec, but the name of it was Brewer. That was like my second home. So that helped a lot too. So, being in that environment, you know, you get caught up in some things. It wasn't always, you know, happy-go-lucky. And I saw that I was heading in a direction that I really didn't want to be when I was playing the role. So, there was one day I was sitting on my porch,
And I'm going to show you Sharon's experience to give you an idea of what the creative life is doing in your life and set you on your path. I was sitting on the front porch, I was like this. And I said these words. I said, you know what? There's more in your life than just this neighborhood. There's more to life than the city of Detroit. There's more to life than the state of Michigan. There's more to life than this country. Then I said, hell, this whole planet is my home. And by me saying that, I activated my journey. I didn't know it at the time, but by me saying this planet was my home, and I meant that. That's why I was saying about the sincerity. I meant that. I didn't know how this was going to happen, but I wanted it. So by me saying this planet is my home, fast forward from that time, which I was around maybe about 1918, somewhere around there, fast forward to this present moment. Excuse me, I have done that, made this planet my home. I lived in the cities I wanted to live in. I was able to live on an island, lived in Honolulu, Hawaii, California, Houston, Atlanta, Georgia. And now I'm in another country, Osaka, Japan, and about to relocate to Thailand. So, I'm not saying this, I hope it don't sound like I'm boasting or bragging or like this, but I'm just sharing what's possible at the moment. Mainly talking to the young people. But, you know, the elders, you know, of course, it's towards you as well, but it's more so for, again, young kids out of the future. So, saying what I said is now a reality. So, just through the years, I mean, I can share a lot of stories, but the thing is, when you really want what you want, it's possible for you to have. And that's no joke. And what I do now, you know, I enjoy it a lot. It allowed me to see the joy in people's faces, you know, to see this old guy with a toy. So, fantastic. He's also known as Viper Charm. But, you know, just going around and just see the joy of just having this stuffed animal, you know, taking pictures or whatever. And, you know, when people see him, it's like, first thing I notice is a smile. You know, all ages, male, female. So it just let me know that, you know, I'm being guided in the right direction. So that's what I wanted to share. You know, I'm not experienced doing this. This is the first time. You know, who knows? Maybe this might be another discovery that I might enter into, which, you know, may allow me to become more polished, used as a tool as I go forth in this journey. Even with the music, you know, because one guy I was listening to, he was telling me about game. Now, I don't know much about that, because, you know, I don't spend time in that area. But even with music, you know, not a singer, not a rapper, I don't play no instrument, but I was able to find the talent that I have within me that I can arrange sound. And that all came from someone telling me what I probably can do. I didn't accept it right away, but I was open to it. And then as time went on, you know, I said, well, let me try. And discovered that I had the ability to actually arrange sound. And it's just not me just saying, this is professional singers that I know in Japan telling me, you know. So again, it reflects to, you know, the young guys, you know, or anyone. If you find something within you, just do it. And I understand now it's okay. Still fantastic, awesome, magnificent. All the words that, you know, relate to that. It just gets better as you go. And that was part of the creation of fantastic. You know, for the moments of despair, disappointment, frustration. And if you're in that mood and you just happen to see a fantabulous image anywhere, he just let you know that you're fantabulous. You're amazing. That's what he was created for.